Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
How's it going, everybody? I'm Paul Cheon here, and as much as I was tempted to draft Cube again, I figured this time I want to help you guys practice for the Modern PTQ season because it is Modern right now. So this is almost card for card Owen Turtenwall's list of blue-red Splinter Twin, except he played three Twisted Images and I only got to play it in one daily event, but Twisted Images were a little bit subpar. So I'm deciding to just try a Miser's One Of and playing a copy of Flame Slash, which, you know, does the same thing a lot of the time that Twisted Image does. I mean, it doesn't draw you the card, but it still does its job in killing Spellskite. And then we have one random copy of Peak as well, just to have extra information. Because I don't really want to be playing two Flame Slashes in the main deck. I guess I could have tried two Twisted Image, but I'm just playing a little one of everything and seeing just kind of what I like best and what I want more, like, most of the time. And if I find that there's a clear favorite between these one ofs, I will choose to go with that. Versatility is nice, however. But basically, this is the stock blue-red Splinter Twin deck. You know, one thing I really like about this deck is, you know, it's one of the best game one decks out there. But post sideboard, you just basically can turn into just a blue moon deck where you just board in the package of basically Batter Skulls and Blood Moon. And I suppose one copy of Grim Lawmancer is what I have here. And yeah, you can just grind out a lot of opponents, surprisingly, because you have burn spells and Snapcaster Mages and Vendilion Clicks, Cryptic Commands, and Serum Visions and stuff like that to basically allow you to sculpt a hand where you can just cast the Blood Moon in some matchups. You know, the matchups that bring in a ton of hate cards against you usually are susceptible to Blood Moon. So I like having the ability to be able to get the free wins in Blood Moon. Aside from that, we have the one random copy of Tectonic Edge, which has been surprisingly effective. That is definitely an open slot, though. You could, you know, I've seen people play two Tectonic Edges and something like a Desolate Lighthouse, but I do think your mana is very important, especially after boarding into the Blood Moon plan. And, you know, anytime you have a game where you have multiple Tectonic Edges or multiple non-blue or red sources in your hand, it's just really, really bad because you have, you know, a lot of heavy mana requirements because, you know, for the most part, your deck is blue. But the fact that you're playing, you know, double red cards and a copy of Kiki Jiki makes it so that you really don't ever want to have, like, two Tectonic Edges in your opening hand. I did hear, however, that Desolate Lighthouse has been a house. And in the really grindy matchups, I can see that actually be the case where, you know, especially game one where you're cycling through a bunch of bad cards. I think it's probably worse after sideboard because you're boarding into basically all effective cards. But pre-board, you know, you do have some cards that are not as strong in certain matchups. So the Lighthouse does do some work, I hear. And we have basically the four Misties, four Scaldings, Steam Vents, and then we have the one Stomping Ground. Some people talk about preferring Breeding Pool, but I'm going with the Stomping Ground here. And the reason why we have the Stomping Ground here, obviously, is because of the Ancient Grudges in the sideboard. One of the best cards against Affinity. And quickly going over to the sideboard, we have the Anger of the Gods, which is great against, once again, Affinity. And also amazing against Malirapod, which is one of the most popular decks online and in real life. Then, like I said before, Batterskull, Catch All, very effective card against any matchup. I love bringing this card in. Blood Moon, auto wins, helps you against the Tron matchup. You're already good against Tron, but Blood Moon is pretty awesome. Extra copy of Dispel for the control matchups. You got your Echoing Truth. I find that I bring in Echoing Truth a lot, almost all the time, because you never know if they bring in stuff like a Torpor Orb or whatever, and having a cheap, effective answer to basically all the hate cards is pretty nice. Then we have a random Lavamancer here. Ooh, looks like the tournament started, so we're going to start soon. Just as, you know, another way to get value. I don't like having too many because we have stuff like Snapcaster Mage and Anger of the Gods. But I want to try the Grim Lavamancer, especially when we're going with this strategy. It's pretty nice to have another early way to deal with, you know, low drop creatures. To round it out, we have Relic of Progenitus, obviously for the graveyard decks, and Threads of Disloyalty for Zoo, pretty much. And mostly Tarmogoyfs. Tarmogoyfs are pretty annoying. Outside of that, like I said, very, very stock. Seven Visions, Bolt, Reman, Snapcaster. We have our six tappers, or six ways to win with basically five ways to go infinite with Splinter Twin and Kikijiki. But the great part about Splinter Twin Kikijiki, they're also pretty strong with Snapcaster Mage. You can get a lot of value like that. So yeah, this is the deck. About to hop into a Modern, and let's see how it goes.